More than a decade after Jackass 3D, Jackass Forever reunites the original cast more than two decades after the reality television stunt show launched. Certainly older, but not necessarily wiser, ringleader Johnny Knoxville leads his troupe through a variety of graphic, surreal, and brutal stunts. No bodily organ is spared, no bodily fluid is sacred. Don't try this at home, kids. In fact, don't try this anywhere. Jackass Forever is the kind of film that is, almost by definition, review-proof. It is crass, vulgar, hilarious, shocking, inventive, sadistic, voyeuristic, witty, juvenile, creative, playful, experimental, violent, and excessive. Those are all value-neutral attributes, and one suspects that, 20 years into the routine, most of the audience already knows what they think of it. Still, it is interesting to think about Jackass Forever, to try to contextualize and understand the phenomenon. For all that its pleasures might seem both simple and tasteless, and for all that its own creators might dispel attempts to read too much into it, there is a certain artistry to the vulgarity on display. Whatever one might think of the content, Jackass 3D remains one of the most striking uses of the three-dimensional format. Spike Jonze, the director of experimental movies like Being John Malkovich and Adaptation, has been part of the troupe since the beginning. He even makes small appearances in Jackass Forever. So, having about 2 minutes left on the clock, let's indulge ourselves. Let's take a moment to try to understand Jackass. It's possible to look at Jackass as the intersection of three overlapping traditions in entertainment, particularly American entertainment: the freak show, the silent comedy, and early reality television. Knoxville's injuries on previous Jackass projects largely relegate him to the role of host in Forever. In that capacity, Knoxville is flamboyant and loud. He frequently changes costumes, he makes tacky jokes, and he is outlandish. He resembles nothing so much as a carnival barker, drawing the audience in to watch the spectacle of a freak show. In this way, the outlandish stunts of Jackass resemble old traveling fairs and stage shows, freaks and geeks, updated for more contemporary sensibilities. Of course, the absurd and often reckless stunts undertaken by the Jackass team also evoke the earliest of silent film performers. Many of those performers, like Charlie Chaplin and Buster Keaton, made the leap from vaudeville into cinema, and in doing so, codified the language of films around stunt and spectacle. Many of their stunts were just as risky as those undertaken by this team. Studies of silent cinema often overlook or downplay the extent to which their legacy lives on in modern stunt work, something acknowledged by films like the John Wick franchise. Jackass is arguably just as much a part of that tradition. Is there so much difference between Tom Cruise leaving in footage of breaking his ankle in Mission Impossible Fallout, and Johnny Knoxville acknowledging the severe injuries that he endured filming Jackass Forever? After all, part of the appeal of Jackass is the surreal humor that underlies many of the stunts, the absurd escalations and the ridiculous contrivances. Knoxville may not be as far from classic Hollywood tradition as one might think, just, you know, with more overt dick jokes. Finally, Jackass is inescapably a product of the reality television landscape of the 90s, where authenticity was packaged and sold, and anyone with an affordable video camera could try to be a star. There's perhaps something to admire in the way that the cast of Jackass retained control of their narrative. Part of the appeal of something like Jackass Forever is in watching old friends reunited, seemingly hoping to amuse themselves as much as the audience watching in a cinema. There's a palpable joy on display here. Then again, maybe it's just funny to watch people getting hit in the crotch. I don't know. Jackass Forever is in theaters now.